Okay, welcome to another session of Sailing Finland Camera Corner. Today I'm going to take a look at how to generate transcripts for videos that I'm editing in DaVinci Resolve when the language spoken in the video is not one of the languages supported natively by Resolve. So a few versions back, Resolve actually got this new very interesting feature that you can generate transcripts from the audio. But the language selection in Resolve is pretty limited. And if you want to make videos in some other languages, then you have to look for some other means to generate the transcript. So in my case, for instance, that other language is Finnish. Also, often if you do videos in another language, you might want to generate translated transcripts into some languages. And often, actually, I want to do English versions also of the transcript so that my videos that I made in Finnish might be accessible to people actually not very good at fluent at Finnish. So are there solutions for this? And yes, now it turns out that recently, you know, a new piece of software has come on the market that actually is very helpful in this respect. So let's see what that is. So basically the solution is built around an open source audio processor called Audacity. Audacity is open source, so it's free to download. You can download it from a place called GitHub. And then Audacity can then be enhanced by a plugin called OpenVINO. And this plugin then actually allows you to both generate transcripts and then translate transcripts into English. You can't translate it into any other language, but you can translate into English. So let's see how this works. So the softwares you can find here on this site called GitHub. I'll put the link under the video. So first thing you have to do then is if you're not already a user of Audacity, then you download Audacity. The latest version right now when I'm doing this is 3.5.1. So you download this and you get the Windows version. So you can see here there's an installer here for Windows. 64-bit version is probably the one that you want to use, so take this one. Then there's an other piece of the equation, and that's a plugin for Audacity by a project called OpenVINO. So they have created a plugin to do these transcripts plus some other things based on artificial intelligence. So again, in order for you to use this, you need to download it. Again, right now the latest version at the time of making this is 3.5 release 2.1, which is a patch version. So probably if you're watching this later, the versions that you want to use are more recent, but these ones at least work. So how do we do? Well, I've actually already installed Audacity, so I'm not going to go through that. It's just a standard piece of a Windows installation. But then let's take a look at then installing the OpenVINO plugin. So just let's start this thing here. So the installation actually consists of a number of parts. So there's actually the basic software, but then you also have various artificial intelligence models that you want to download and use. So basically, I've already installed this, so I don't need to do it, but for Whisper, this is the module that does the speech-to-text, the transcripts. So in my experience, you know, you want large version 2 or large version 3 models. All the smaller models are actually not very useful. The quality of the transcripts are significantly better if you have one of these bigger models. So choose the models that you want to download. As part of the download process, it will not show right now. And then just hit next to do the installation. So here's now the installation going on. And now the installation is done. So now when we are, now we need to open Audacity. Now there's a couple of things you need to do. So first of all, you need to go into the preferences and then change to settings. So first of all, there is here something called modules, and OpenVINO, the plugin, is a module, so you need to enable that. So we enable it here. And then the second thing, in order for us to actually then export SRT files, which we can then import either into Resolve or into, say, directly into YouTube, you need to go into the import export thing and choose one more thing. So you need to change this first one here to extended, and when you do an export, that will then give you the option to also export as an SRT file. So with these things done, you actually have to restart Audacity, so let's do that. And now we basically should be set up in terms of having Audacity ready. So what's the workflow now? The audio in Audacity, I have to export it from Resolve. So how do I do that? I go to the export page here, and then I'm going to generate, let's say, so this is like OpenVINO test. So generate a file called that, the location, I'm going to put it in the videos folder. And then what do I want to do? I don't want to export video, I just want to do audio. And for audio, then I'm going to use the WAV format. You can use some others as well, but this is easiest. And then I'm going to use linear PCM, 16 bits, and sample rate is what is set up for the project. And then the file I have there, so now add this to render queue. So now this is about 2 minutes long, so shouldn't take too long to render out the audio. So now I have the audio file there. So now let's then go into Audacity and then import the audio file. Okay, so in Audacity now I'm going to then open the file, the OpenVINO file. So this is the test that we generated. So let's open up that audio. And then we can see now is it roughly, it's roughly 2 minutes. So this is okay. So now this is the audio track then that we have that I want to generate the transcript from. So how do I do that? There actually are a couple of things that are now included with OpenVINO. So one thing I could do to help with the generation is I could actually run a noise suppression on this, but because this comes from an already processed video, then I don't need to do that. So instead I'm just going to go to analyze, and then here is then generate the whisper transcript. So then I'm going to get this view here. There's quite a limited selection of devices that OpenVINO supports. You can always do the transcription with the CPU, but on my laptop here I actually have an Intel built-in GPU, so I'm going to use that one. And then select the whisper model, so I'm going to use the large version 3. And then I'm going to transcribe. Language selection is auto. Now in this situation, you know, it's not very exciting because it actually is the language that I have there is English, so I can choose that. The auto detection seems to work quite okay. And then for the advanced options, what I might want to do here is set something like max segment length. So that is, again, the number of characters that are going to form sort of one transcript sort of sentence. So I'm going to say about, you know, I want about 60 characters. That's what I typically use on Resolve as well. So then with all these things set, then I can just go ahead and start generating. Okay, so there it was. So it took about 2 minutes to generate the thing, so it's actually not a very fast process. And now you can see here that here we now then have the transcript. The UI for the transcript in Audacity is not very good. So basically my personal preference then is not to edit it, but I mean, if I want to, you know, I can now go in and edit the sections here. So perhaps I want to capitalize the camera corner, so I can do that. But in general, I think then the next step is, the better next step is then to export this. So select the track with the transcripts, select export others, export labels. And now we are actually given the option of exporting as an SRT file. So basically now I can call this, so I'll just call this OpenVINO test. So I will just call it OpenVINO test. And now I have an SRT file that I can use in Resolve. Okay, so that this was what we do in Audacity. Now let's move over back to Resolve. And in Resolve 19, there is this new feature that you can actually then import SRT files. That was not possible earlier. Okay, so let's see if we can now then find the SRT file. So go in here, we have the videos. Is there an SRT file here? It's called OpenVINO test SRT. So here's now the SRT file. So I can drag it in as any other media file. And then I can go over now to the timeline. And now I can just, from the media pool, I can then just drag the SRT file and drag that onto the timeline. And there we have the transcripts. So here's now the transcript generated. And if I now want to, then I can start, for instance, editing here, which I think is actually much simpler and much more user-friendly. So I would do the editing here. So then when I've done that, you know, I can then just, okay, let's do a little change here, so do that modification. And now basically I can then, if I want to generate the SRT file, for instance, for YouTube, I can go into File, Export, Subtitle, and then I can, you know, put here, so this was now English. Same. Okay, that's it. Pretty simple. One more thing about the Audacity thing. Now, if this had been some other language, then what I could have done is I could have gone into then Analyze, Whisper, and then I could change Transcribe into Translate. So this means that it's going to take the source language and translate that into English. Of course, now, in this case, you know, the language here is English, so this doesn't make any sense. But this would then allow you to generate English versions quite easily for many of the languages supported. As far as language quality or transcript quality goes, then I mainly tried Finnish in addition to English, and I must say that I'm very happy with the quality of the Finnish generation. I'm also quite happy with the English translation done from Finnish language. They're not perfect, you always have to edit, but it's still a lot less work than going through any of the other channels that I've so far found to actually do this work. So I think this is a really nice way to then enhance your resolve workflow if you are making videos in any of the other languages that are not supported by Resolve, but you can find here then in Audacity with OpenVINO. Okay, so that was all for today. Thanks for stopping by. And if you like this, then remember to subscribe to Sail in Finland, some camera stuff every now and then. And then, of course, the main output of the site is exciting videos about sailing and boating in Finland. So see you around. Hope to see you next time.